अच्छी वर्मा, चैप्टर 7, क्वेश्चन नंबर 22। अ ट्रैक कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ टू सर्कुलर पार्ट्स ए बी सी एंड सी डी ऑफ इक्वल रेडियस 100 मीटर एंड ज्वाइन स्मूथली एट सोन। ईच पार्ट सबटेंड्स अ राइट एंगल एट इट्स सेंटर। अ साइकिल वेइंग 100 केजी टुगेदर विद द राइडर ट्रेवल्स विद अ कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड ऑफ 18 किलोमीटर पर आवर ऑन द ट्रैक। ए फाइंड द नॉर्मल कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स बाय द रोड ऑन द साइकिल व्हेन इट इज एट बी एंड डी। बी Find the force of friction exerted by the track on the tires when the cycle is at B, C and D. C. Find the normal force between the road and the cycle just before and just after the cycle crosses C. D. What should be the minimum friction coefficient between the road and the tire which will ensure that cyclist can move with constant speed. The speed of the cycle is 18 km per hour which when converted to meter per second turns out to be 5 meters per second. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the cycle rider system when the cycle is at point B. Gravitational force of mg acts on the system in vertically downward direction. If we attach our frame to the cycle, a centrifugal force of magnitude mv square by r acts in vertically upward direction and normal contact force from the road acts in vertically upward direction. Since in our frame the cycle is not accelerating, net force on it must be zero, or n plus mv square by r must be equal to mg, which implies n is equal to mg minus mv square by r. Putting the values, we get n is equal to 100 into 10 minus 100 into 25 divided by 100, that is 1000 minus 25 or 975 newtons. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the cycle rider system in the frame attached to the cycle when the cycle is at point D. Gravitational force of mg acts in vertically downward direction. Since the center of the circular path on which cycle is moving is up above the road, the centrifugal force in this case acts in downward direction. The magnitude of this force is mv square by r. Normal reaction from the road acts in upward direction. Balancing the forces, we get n is equal to mg plus mv square by r. Putting the values, we get n is equal to 1000 plus 25 or 1025 newtons. Thus, the normal at point B is 975 newtons and at point D is 1025 newtons. This is answer to part A of the question. As we have seen in the free body diagram of the cycle at point B, there is no horizontal force acting on the cycle. Also, the acceleration of the cycle is zero, meaning net force on the cycle is zero. Therefore, there is no friction acting on the cycle. Similarly, the friction force is zero at D. Since the arc ABC subtends angle 90 degree at the center of the circle, the C is at 45 degree angle with the vertical. This means the road at C is at 45 degree with the horizontal. Now let us draw the free body diagram of the cycle at point C. Gravitational force of mg acts in vertically downward direction. The component of the gravity along the slope of the road is mg sin theta and the component perpendicular to the road is mg cos theta. The normal contact force from the road, say n, acts perpendicular to the road. Since the road at point C is straight, the motion of the cycle at point C is linear motion and hence no centrifugal force acts on it. Friction force, say F, acts up along the slope. Since the cycle is moving with uniform speed, its acceleration is zero and hence net force in direction along the slope must be zero. Therefore, F must be equal to mg sin theta. Putting the values of m and theta, we get F is equal to 100 into 10 into 1 by root 2. Simplifying, we get F is equal to 500 root 2 or 707 newtons. Thus, the friction force is 0 at points B and D, while it is 707 newtons at point C. This is answer to part B of the question. For part C, let us draw the free body diagram of the cycle when it is just before point C. Like last part, in this case too, gravity will be mg downwards with its component mg sin theta along the slope and mg cos theta perpendicular to it. Normal will act perpendicular to the slope, but in this case the cycle is moving on a circular track which is concaving downward. This means the center of the circle on which the cycle is moving is downward and hence centrifugal force will act upward. Friction will act up along the slope. Balancing the forces in radial direction, we get n plus mv square by r is equal to mg cos theta, which implies n is equal to mg cos theta minus mv square by r. Putting the values, we get n is equal to 100 into 10 into 1 by root 2 minus 100 into 25 by 100. Simplifying, we get n is equal to 707 minus 25 or 682 newtons. As the cycle crosses point C, It is now moving on a circle whose center is upward. So the centrifugal force will now act downwards. Directions of rest of the forces will remain unchanged. Balancing the forces in radial direction, we get N is equal to mv square by r plus mg cos theta. Putting the values, we get N is equal to 25 plus 707 or N is equal to 732 newtons. Thus, just before point C, normal contact force is 682 newtons and just after C, it is 732 newtons. This is answer to part C of the question. Cycle is moving with constant speed along the track, so net force on the cycle has to be zero. Therefore, the component of gravity along the slope must be balanced by the friction. The inclination of the track is maximum around point C. So the coefficient of friction must be large enough to prevent slipping of the cycle around point C. If mu be the value of coefficient of friction, then mu n must be equal to mg sin theta. We have seen that the normal just before C is minimum and equal to 682 newtons. Therefore, mu into 682 must be equal to 100 into 10 into 1 by root 2. Or mu is equal to 707 by 682. Thus, mu is equal to 1.037. This is answer to part D of the question. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.